हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू योर यूट्यूब चैनल रसायन शास्त्री। गाइस, एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द एग्जाम कॉल्ड टेक्सटाइल कमिटी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टेक्सटाइल। रिगार्डिंग द सेम, हियर इट इज अ वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज पार्ट टू। लेट मी फर्स्ट रिवाइंड यू व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज पार्ट वन। आई डिस्कस सिलेबस ऑफ टेक्सटाइल कमिटी, व्हाट आर द रिसोर्सेज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल व्हाट आर द रिसोर्सेज फॉर केमिस्ट्री हैज बीन ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। Now, in this video lecture series part 2, I am going to discuss about the textile chemistry. Okay, guys? Textile chemistry. Here we will discuss what is the syllabus of textile chemistry and its important concept. So, let's start. Proceeding to textile chemistry, I actually bifurcated the syllabus into various small parts. Okay? That environmental portion of this syllabus is actually the waste product generated during the textile industry. Okay? First important part is types of fiber. In this video lecture is part 2, we are going to discuss about the different type of fibers only. Now you have to remember what are the examples of each fibers. Okay, the next is manufacturing of man-made textiles part, that is the video lecture is part 3, where I am going to discuss the manufacturing process of man-made textile, technical textile, and then again textile finishing. These two will be together. Okay, now textile testing. And this is your actually environmental portion. As per the syllabus, we need to learn the waste generated in textile industry. That is the effluent treatment. Okay, what is effluent? Effluent is basically any kind of waste material generated in any of the industries. Here in textile industry, that excess amount of water so generated after the preparation of your different kind of fabric, we need to learn the different kind of process for the treatment of that effluent. We cannot dump that effluent directly in the land or in the sea. Okay, we need to first treat that effluent. Okay, that effluent has different chemical properties. So in textile effluent analysis, we need to learn about oxygen demand, that is BOD, COD, okay, and lot many things are there. Okay, so let's start. Today's topic of discussion is types of fiber. My friend, listen carefully. We're going to discuss each and every aspect of this textile chemistry slowly slowly. Before starting the classification, let me first introduce you what is textile and what is the fiber basic definition. So textile is basically an umbrella term, it is basically a very broad term that contains different kind of fiber based material, that is our apparels, yarns, filament, threads, and different type of fibers. Okay, fiber and fabric, these are the terms we are using interchangeably. So in textile, it involves our apparel, sofas, bed sheet, lining, Teflon. It is also one kind of textile. Okay, so it is a umbrella term. What is fiber? Fiber is basically the smallest part of fabric. Smallest part of fabric means I have made a chart regarding the formation of a textile from the molecules. Okay, so if you break the textile in smaller part, you will be getting the very small part called fiber. If you further break that fiber into smaller part, we will be getting the molecules. Okay, so basically we have a fiber. That fiber is nothing but a hair like fine structure. When that fiber is grouped and twisted, leads to the formation of continuous array. That continuous array is called yarns. Some fibers are grouped to each other and it is twisted, is little formation of yarns. From that yarns, we are making different kind of textile materials. For example, woman fabric, knitted fabrics, lace, that is a yarns. Okay, main hindi mein bolta hu. Women ke fabrics mein aap dekhoge chote chote jo laces nikle hue hote hain, usi ko yarn bola jata hai. Okay, so textile fiber, as you guys already know, textile is an umbrella term, fiber is again an umbrella term. Okay, we have a different kind of fibers, but in this industry we are focusing on the apparel industry. Okay, textile industry. So textile fiber, what is textile fiber? Basically, textile fibers are visible fundamental unit from which fabrics are made. When we are going to, for example, if you want to make a shirt, for that shirt we need a fabric, for that fabric we need a yarn, for that yarn we need a polymer, then molecules. Okay, it is like that. In today's world, we are using different kind of materials for the preparation of apparels. Okay, we have woolen clothes, we have a silk saris, we have a cotton dresses, we have a jute based material. Okay, few fabrics are used for the formation of an apparel, but few fabrics, because of its chemical and physical property, use for the formation of bed lining. Okay, for the formation of bags, jute bags, gunny bags. Each fiber has a particular property. So textile fiber is actually made of a molecule. That fiber molecule is called polymer. Let me first discuss this in detail. Textile fiber from monomer to fabric. Okay, what actually it happens from fabric, it leaves the textile. Okay, and then first there's a monomer. Okay, there is smallest part. Then when lot of monomers combines, it leaves the formation of polymer. For example, if we have a silk fabric, that silk fabric is nothing but the protein-based fabric. I'm going to discuss in detail. That silk fabric is basically the protein-based fiber, and that protein is actually the polymer of amino acids. So that amino acid is a monomer. When amino acid combines by the condensation reaction, it leads to formation of polymer. That is a protein, single chain proteins. When lot of protein molecules or polymers combine, it leads to formation of fibers. So amino acid, next step is polymer, next step is fiber. Now, when lot of fibers combine and twisted and grouped in an array called yarn, and from that yarn, we have a fabric. And from that fabric, we have a textile. Okay, so this is the process of formation of textile from the molecules. Okay, the glycine, this is one of the very smallest amino acid. Okay, now the most important part is classification of fibers. Before starting the classification of fiber, we need to understand first, previously or in ancient period, this textile industry is the ancient industry, or textile is not a new word, or it is not a new industry. It is one of the very ancient industries. Previously, the classification based on very, very simple, it was a very simple classification. Once there is a French organization which classified the fibers on its generic name. I'm going to discuss that also. So, previously, the classification was only three classifications. Natural fibers, that may be vegetable, animal, okay. And that from that natural fiber, we are making man-made materials, okay. So nowadays, many of the systems are available. Fibers are further subclassified. Classification of fiber, it basically fibers are classified on the basis of its generic name. Generic name means from the source, from which material or what is the source of that fiber. That classification based on the source. There is a French organization which is actually responsible for allocating the generic name to the fibers. That name of the organization is Bureau International Purla Standardization Des Fabric Artificiales, BISFA. Okay, just remember the abbreviation carefully, because in a MCQ question they can ask. For the very first classification is textile fiber, natural or man-made. So it may be natural, naturally further classified into various, man-made further classified into various. Okay, so very simple, understand natural fibers and man-made fibers. Guys, remember, man-made fibers and synthetic fiber, they are the two different terms. Man-made fiber are not synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber are the type of man-made fiber. Okay, so natural fiber basically depends upon the source from where that fiber we get. Okay, natural fibers are further classified into, further subclassified into various type of fibers. Man-made fiber further classified into various other subclassifications. So this is the broad picture. I highly recommend you guys take the printout of this page and paste it on your wall. Try to remember this chart. This is going to help you a lot. First classification is natural fiber and man-made fiber. Okay. Now, man-made fibers, basically it are of three types. Depending upon the source, it may be the vegetable source. Vegetable source means plant-based, animal and protein-based. Third is mineral. There is only one textile, which is a mineral-based textile, asbestos. And now it is discarded. It is not in use because of its hazardous character. So textile are two types, natural fibers and man-made fibers. Natural fibers, depending upon the source, it may be plant, that is vegetable fiber, or animal-based fiber, that is protein fiber. So vegetable fiber means cellulose-based fiber. Cellulose is basically a polymer of a glucose. Okay, understand. So cellulose-based fiber or protein. So cellulose-based fiber is further classified. It may be jute, okay? It may be cotton. For example, what is the source? If we get that fiber from the bamboo part, that is called jute-based fiber. If we get the fiber from the seed part, there is the cotton-based fiber. Cotton, coir, or kapas, or kopak, like this. Okay, this is very limited in use. Now, next is animal protein-based fiber. Depending upon the source of that protein, the further classified. It may be wool fiber, for example, the hair of the sheep's. Okay, then again, hair fibers. Then again, silk fibers. Basically, these all are protein-based fiber. You guys already understand, if it is a protein-based fiber, its monomer is actually amino acid. Now, for vegetable fiber, it is cellulose based fiber. Its monomer may be amylase or glucose. Okay. Man-made fiber are further classified in natural polymers. Again, man-made fibers are of the classified depending upon how they are formed. That is again so inorganic and synthetic based. Okay. So man-made fibers, the first one is natural polymer. So natural polymers are basically the type of fibers that are made from natural fibers by some modification. For example, we have vegetable cellulose based fiber, which is a natural fiber. So if we do some modification in the cellulose, we will get natural based polymer. Okay, that is a natural polymer. The first one is cellulose rayon. We are going to discuss in detail. Next one is cellulose ester. Okay, then others. Cellulose rayon, cellulose ester, these are basically regenerative cellulose based natural polymer man-made fibers. Inorganic is glass, carbon, metal. Synthetic fiber, they are not in use of textile industry. They are in different industry. Synthetic fiber are those fibers or the textile fiber which are made from non-fibrous materials or from non-renewable source of energy. First one is polyvinyl derivatives. Polyvinyl derivatives, you guys already know, this group is called vinyl group. First one is polyvinyl alcohol, then PVC, polyvinyl chloride, UPVC, CPVC, polyacrylate nitrile. Teflon is again a one kind of your textile fiber. Okay, polyamide, polyesters, polyethylene or polyolefin, polyurethane. Okay, some benzene based. So, as per our syllabus, we need to learn this natural fiber thing, everything about this natural fiber and man-made fiber, that is natural polymer. We do not need to learn about this. So the first one is vegetable fiber. The first one is natural fiber. Among the natural fiber, the classification is vegetable fiber and the cotton. Okay, cotton is basically a cellulose based natural fiber. So cotton is basically the hair attached seed of several species. That is a Gossypium is the name of the genus whose seed has some hairs. That hair is called cotton. Okay. The shrubs may be height of 2 meters in height. Basically, these cotton-based fibers are produced in warm, humid climate. Okay. Or sandy soil. There is a black soil is also called as cotton. Okay. For the formation of the cotton-based plant, there is a soil called black. Another characteristic of cotton fiber, if we watch the cotton fiber with naked eyes, it seems like a very, very simple fiber. But when we magnify it, it will be seen like it is actually the layer of many tiny fibrils. Okay, that arrange in a single, definite spiral pattern. Okay, having a right angle to each other. Another property of natural fibers is a vegetable based cellulose fiber. Cotton flowers are nectar, and if beekeeping is planned, it gives a highly flavored, healthy and tasty honey. That means that Gossypium plants, if we do the beekeeping, it will lead to the formation of tasty honey. Next, natural fiber, that is a vegetable fiber, cellulose based, is a jute. Okay, as you guys already know, India is one of the leading producer of jute. So it's the world most plentiful and cheapest fiber, weakest and cheapest fiber. Jute is mainly grown in India, Pakistan and Brazil. Generally, jute is not used in apparel. That is, कपड़े बनाने के लिए जूट का इस्तेमाल कम होता है. But it is basically it is used for bulletin of 40 boards, furniture, slips, covers, like. It has limited use in apparel. Now, next natural fiber is animal based fiber. That is a protein based fiber. Protein based means keratin or animal fiber. The first one is wool, the protein based fiber. So wool is the first fiber that man learned to make into fabric. Okay. By either felting or mating. Wool, what is the source of the wool? Basically, these are the hair of sheep. Wool is basically natural protein fiber. As I already told you regarding the process of formation of a fiber from monomer to fabric, it is basically the chain of amino acid. When amino acid react by condensation reaction followed by the removal of water leads to the formation of a chain. That is called via peptide linkage. What is peptide linkage? This linkage is called peptide linkage. Okay, basically amide linkage. And since we have a different kind of amino acids, that amino acid called cysteine, which has sulfur-sulfur linkage. So in wool-based fibers, that sulfur-sulfur linkage is basically the weakest part of the wool. That's why that will be undergo different kind of reactions with oxidizing agent as well as reducing agent. Means if sunlight or any kind of harsh chemicals falls on the wool, it will lead to the discoloration because of the cleavage of the sulfur-sulfur bond. Now, next and very important fiber is your animal-based fiber called natural protein fiber silk. It is called the queen of all textile fiber. Okay, what is the source of formation of a silk? It is basically the protein-based fiber. That is again the animal fiber. So in India, there are some insects, caterpillars that are actually producing that protein chains for the formation of a silk. What are the name of this caterpillars? Mulberry silkworm, Bombyx mori. Okay, these are the actually commercially produced silk fibers. And in a question, they may ask that what are the caterpillars or what are the silk forming caterpillars? Okay, there is a definite industry regarding the silk that is called sericulture. Sericulture means there are a lot of people who are actually cultivating this caterpillar for the formation of silk. Okay, and they will sell the silk to large industry. This complete industry is called as sericulture. Man-made fibers, the further classified into, it may be natural polymers, it may be synthetic as well. So what are the natural polymers? Basically, these natural polymers are the type of man-made fibers which are made from natural fibers. That means we have a natural fibers. That natural fibers contains molecules. There's some modification in that molecules will lead to the formation of man-made fiber. The first one is rayons. Cellulosic fiber. That means we have a cellulose fiber, that is cotton. Cotton-based cellulose fiber. If we do some kind of modification in that cellulose chain, it will lead to the formation of rayons. Rayon is manufactured fiber. Manufactured fiber means regenerated via cellulose. Regenerated cellulose fiber in which 15% of the hydroxyl group is replaced by some other groups. Okay, that means OH group, that hydrogen of this OH group of the cellulose is replaced by maybe nitro group, maybe ester group. Depending upon that, we have a nitrocellulose. Depending upon that, we have a cellulose ester based fiber. And the first commercially based rayon is nitrocellulose. That means hydrogen is replaced by nitro group. Most of the rayons are maybe your nitrocellulose or acetate based group. For example, if you have a OH, that OH is become like this. This is called your acetate based cellulose. This nitro based cellulose are actually used for the preparation of different kind of lot, tents, carpet rugs, curtains, bedspreads, coat, nighted wear, suits, blouses, skirts, lot of things are there. Okay, so my friend, this is all about the classification of the textile fibers. If you want this PPT, it is available in my Telegram channel. If you want the book or complete notes regarding this textile chemistry, guys, you have to buy it. Okay, if you are interested, let me know. I will give you the details how to buy that book. If you want this PPT, it is freely available in my Telegram channel. Okay, so here we discuss the classification of fibers. In the next video, there is a video lecture series part 3 of textile chemistry. We will be discussing the manufacturing process. Okay. So my friend, till now, stay tuned to Shastrii YouTube channel for more such latest updates. Thank you.